Mini educator or educator for bloodhound pups had to get a boss for their dad, but we adopted him after he got fired from being a hunting dog and was high drive chasing deer, etc. Was able to call him off without getting to the highest boss levels.
Some bloodhounds, any fill in the blank breed needs more stimulation.
Yeah.
But there's bloodhounds that are probably low level correctors.
Right.
So, I mean, it doesn't hurt to get the boss. Like my father always said, Jeff, when you buy a briefcase, get one of the bigger size briefcases because you can always not use it all. But if you get a small briefcase and you need more, you're out of luck. Mm. Irv's got good advice like that.
It's true.
Hey, we're live. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing?
Stopping by to give thanks. Continuing education for dog owners.
Awesome. Dogs just stop doing bad shit. It's incredible. And then you get to start training your dog. Here we are. We're Wednesday. We were in a consulting gig for the last 2 days. So we missed the Monday show just because we weren't available. And then we're not going to be doing, any shows at all next week. We're not going to be doing a show on Friday. So this is what we're going to do. This is the What Would Jeff Do show. It's a Q&A show. You ask a question, type in the box below. Shell P, you're already asking too many questions. Cut it out. And Joelle will read them. I'll answer them. What Would Jeff Do show? And then we've got something called Jeff Gellman Seminars. And both of those things are geared towards problem solving. Solving dogs' problems. That's what we do. Bad behavior. So a lot of the people are going to be asking questions on how do I stop, how do I stop, how do I stop? So if you've never watched the show before, you can hear me use the word punishment a lot. Punishment has been hijacked by people that consider it abuse, but it's not. It's just the opposite of a reward. Reward gets you more of stuff. Applied punishment gets you less of stuff. Now, the thing is, most people do not know how to properly apply it. Nobody's teaching it. We teach it. There's a couple of people that teach it. So we also have the training center, which does a little bit of everything. And the training center is where we're sitting. And let's go for the ride. Here we go.
Okay, Michelle P. gave my worst offender an act of God correction on the e-collar for charging the fence. Bonkers were not working. He was already in drive. Now he does his business outside and parks himself by the back door when he's done. I'd like him to relax a bit and hang out outside. Will he relax more with time, or should I do something about him wanting in right away? I did, however, solve him freaking out in the crate whenever my son came out of his room because he would anticipate getting let out and go nuts. So that was a win.
So it sounds like things are going pretty well. I would leave it all alone. All alone. You stopped multiple behaviors, but when you stop an unwanted behavior, then the dog gets a little bit confused. Now they don't know what to do. So the dog is figuring it out. He might think the whole backyard is hot. Mm-hmm. So don't worry about it. Leave it alone, Michelle. You're doing great. Michelle, it's the most you've ever talked to us before.
Ever.
Ever. I don't think she's ever asked a question. She's given us money. She says hi.
She talks about like sex toys and stuff a lot.
Right. Did you throw a sex toy at that dog to stop it? Next.
Barking Bakers. Hi, J&J. I have an easily excitable dog. E-collar corrections seem to amp him up rather than stop or settle him. Especially on walks, loud whining, e-collar corrections seem to make him whine louder.
So your time, Barking Bakers, your timing is off. What you'll need to do is, this often does happen. So you're adding fuel to the fire. So that might not be the right correction. So a bonker is great. Heel taps are great. Anything that you can do to stop an unwanted behavior. So, but if your timing is off, if the dog is already escalating, then you are going to usually get more of it sometimes. You could also be underwhelming the dog on the remote. That could be happening. Next.
Kathy B. Oh, wait, hold on. Sid. Hey, J&J, how do I explain to a customer that too much affection and babying to her new timid, nervous dog can produce unwanted anxiety in general, not just in the crate, 2 weeks, and dog showing signs?
So you just explained to her the same way you explained to me. Say, you're literally ruining your dog. You're rewarding your dog for being a basket case. Mm-hmm. No disrespect to anybody that's struggling with, issues. But you're rewarding your dog. That's literally what you do. So that doesn't mean you hit the dog. But But what it means is you work the dog, confidence building. So she's holding on to the story where love and affection is going to make a nervous, fearful dog better. I'm not saying don't give your dog love and affection. I'm saying work the dog. The best thing you can do for a nervous, fearful dog is work the dog. Next.
Kathy B. Hey, everyone. Missed Friday's live. Holiday had my days mixed up.
No problem. We did a show on Friday. Yeah, we were in town. Yeah, we did a show on Friday. It's a good show. You missed a good show, Kathy B. No worry about it.
Courtney, hi, J&J. I'm training my 5.5-month-old Labradoodle with anxiety aggression issues. How long is he expected to be in a down on place? If he breaks, do we bonk him or is there a different punishment for this?
So, Courtney, number one, I don't know how long you've been working on it. So we have dogs that do 5 or 6 hour downs, 5 or 6 hour places, but they've been working on it for a little bit. Then there's also different ways you have to learn how to, I don't know how you trained him either. So there's a lot of components to this. The last thing we're doing is just walking around bonking dogs and correcting dogs on e-collars. That's not what we do. We do well practiced, timely, highly effective, you know, corrections that are used by millions of people around the world. So what I'm saying is there's a protocol to it. There's actually a proper way to apply a punisher. So you always say no first, but then you should have a leash on the dog. If the dog breaks command, say no, apply that punisher. And then if it'd be first time you do it, you might have to guide the dog back. But if you've done hundreds of reps yet, and as far as the first time you do it, you're not going to expect the dog to do it for, you know, an hour, but 2-3 hours in place is a very reasonable amount of time. It's not unreasonable at all. Next.
Melissa said, good evening, all.
Hey, Melissa, how are you?
Kathleen just popping in to say, hey. Hey, Kathleen.
Oh, hey, Kathleen, how are you?
Diana said, hello, all.
Hey, Diana.
Sid, P.S. Jeff, thank you for teaching the choke out method. Had to use it on new client's dog that lunged at my face. It worked. He was muzzled as well. Self-preservation 101.
So, Sid, yep, that's me. Choke him out. If they don't do a downstay or they come and try to bite you, well, that's where the narrative is. You know, Jeff chokes out dogs that don't do downstays. I'm like, no, I don't. Give me a break.
They lunge at your face, though.
When they lunge at your face, it's like people don't understand. There's so many people out there.
Like, wouldn't that be anyone's first reflex? Or you're just going to be like, bite me. Like, wouldn't you at least try to save your ass?
I've seen people totally panic and not know what to do with a dog like
lunging at their face.
Yeah, somebody made a comment on our YouTube channel this morning. I banned it. I just deleted it. It's like the dog was biting her feet. The thing about the dog bites her feet. Mm-hmm. That was the video. And I'm like, just correct it with a remote collar. And she's like, oh my God, those should be horrific. You know, that's just going to make the dog, you know, all the imagine harm stuff.
Yeah.
And she's like, I've been working on this for a while too. And I'm like, we stop it in 1 second.
Mm-hmm.
I said, we stop it in 1 second. So tell me exactly how you're working on it, how long you've been working on it.
Yeah.
And what does it look like? Because it takes us 1 second to stop it. So why is it that it's okay for your dog to bite your feet, but it's not okay to apply a punisher to your dog? That's what I'm still really trying to figure out.
I know.
Why is it okay for your dog to inflict bodily harm on you, but it's not okay for you to often to give your dog a 1 second piece of discomfort? Well practiced, unemotional, mm-hmm. No yelling, no screaming.
Yeah.
Why can't you say no? Correct. Dog right. Stops biting. The dog literally stops biting your feet.
Mm-hmm.
Just like that.
How did we get two little puppies to be quiet in a crate today?
Bonked them.
Bonked the crate. They probably got bonked 5 times today, that crate. Yep. Guess what? Puppies are sleeping.
They're sleeping, yeah. Because no one's ever given them. If you don't know what we're talking about, we have 4 little doodles with us.
2 little doodles.
Did I say 4?
Yeah. I don't think I can handle 4. Already, littermate
they're,
doodles.
They're already multiplying.
They're all right, so little.
Next.
Michelle P. 999. I have asked questions before, and Jeff, you're the one who gets me started. Here's some money.
So Michelle, if I keep giving you a hard time, you keep giving me cash.
Sounds like a good relationship to
damn.
Me.
Damn. It's usually like Joelle's, that's what she does. She gives me a hard time and I've got to give her money just to pay her to stop.
It's a great position to be in.
Next.
Courtney. Hi. Thank you so much.
She said.
5.5-month-old Labradoodle. If he doesn't go in his crate when commanded, he goes in no problem with a treat. Do we bonk him or use a treat instead until he's older?
No. So you don't bonk the dog. for not going in the crate. How many crate drills have you done with leash pressure? So how many times have you put a leash on the dog, stood in front of the crate, and say, kennel up, don't say anything at all. So this is what you do. This is exactly how we treat do crate. Leash on the dog. Walk up to the crate. Guide the dog into the crate. If the dog doesn't want to go, pull him in. Push him, pull him. Okay? Anything that get him in the crate. Close the door. Open the door. If the dog tries to rush out, slam the door. Open the door. Dog pauses, say break, dog comes out. You should be doing that 20 times a day. Okay? 20 times a day. Once the dog is going involuntarily or with minimal leash pressure, then you name it. Got it?
Holding on dog training. Great to see you both. Sending love and appreciation. The male baby is badass. LOL.
Nice. Nice.
Diana ordered tickets for Nashville seminar today. So excited.
Yeah, Nashville's going to be fun. It's going to be a good time. Yeah. So a lot of tickets this week. A lot of action. Next.
Kathleen, you guys planning on doing a marathon show on New Year's Eve? It was so fun when you did it last year. Ringing in the new year.
Did we do it last year?
Yeah. We do it every year.
What are we going to do? Just three. You can't do like a 6-hour show, though.
Hell no.
How much?
You can probably do two.
Can maybe. You?
10 to midnight? I don't know. Let's God. I'm like such an old lady these days. I cannot hang.
Is that what we did?
1 year we did 8 to midnight. We did 4 freaking hours. That was the first year I started working for you. So 2018.
Linda did half. She did half. And I sat there for 4 fucking hours. I didn't move once. I mean, I think I got up to pee maybe. Maybe not. Next. I don't know if we're going to do one yet.
Irene. Hi, J&J. Happy Wednesday.
Hello. How are you?
Emma. How to get dogs to listen better while playing with one another?
Well, this is the thing, Emma, is the playing with one another is a high level distraction.
Yeah.
So number one, is the dog proficient in the command with no distraction? And then you have to start getting the dog to be proficient in the command with a distraction. So if you remote collar train the dogs, then you can start getting their attention. If your dogs know the out command, that also will, when you say that, they'll actually break off from each other. So, but again, this is all training. It's all training, but train them first with no distraction, start adding distractions in, and then take it from there. Next.
Laura. Hello guys. Happy Wednesday. Just got my mini educator today. Spoiled myself by getting an upgrade from my old unreliable $35 e-collar. I'm one happy camper. Watched your videos to get it all set up and fitted properly. Thanks, Jeff.
Awesome. So, Laura, good. So if you watch an old video that says to use Boost, don't use Boost. Take it off Boost. We don't use Boost anymore. Next.
Sunflower said hello.
Hey, Sunflower. How are you?
CMM, 5.5-month-old puppy gets aggressive.
That's like the third 5.5-month-old puppy.
I know. Gets aggressive, but is good most of the time. Comes in the door and zooms in. Sometimes I don't have the bonker. How to discipline with a martingale. I'm practicing with going to his place.
So, number one, the dog should be on a leash. Have the dog come in. Have it come in to you. Recall to you to a sit. Recall to you to a down. Walk it over to place. That's what you do. Martingale, you can't really correct the dog very well. Get yourself a proper prong collar. But again, you need to do proactive training first. Proactive training next.
$4.99 from Zach. Frank died. Cancer got him at 2 years old. Oh my God. Didn't know he had it till an hour before putting him down. I want to thank you for your free content.
Oh my God. An hour.
So sorry,
Jesus
Zach.
Christ. Zach.
It's never easy.
It sucks. Nobody wins. Not only does nobody win, but nobody can tell you how to grieve.
No.
So, Zach, all I can say is, however you grieve, it's the correct way. Unless you harm yourself, please don't do that. That's not the correct way. Like, I want to join Zach. You know, I mean, I want to join my dog, Frank. So, all I can do is tell you, when you're ready to get another dog, there are millions of dogs that are up for adoption right now that would probably love to have you as an owner. So, next.
Another $4.99 from Zach. He said, your content let me have a great relationship with him, and he had a great life. Had I not found your podcast, I wouldn't have even had him.
Wow.
Wow.
Well, Zach, I'm glad I can give you those 2 years.
Yeah.
I'm really very humbled and thank you so much for your kind words. And I'm really sorry about your loss. And whether they die at 2 years old or 12 years old, the pain's the same, man.
Yeah.
The pain is the same. It sucks. Always sucks.
Sure always does. Sucks.
Yeah. Next.
Kaylani said, hey, guys.
Hey, Kaylani. How are you?
Kathy B., I heard you guys say Virginia seminar, but it's a year away. Damn. I'll still see you in Florida. Maybe Virginia, too, though.
Well, Kathy, we do something called seminar planning, where we plan seminars. So we don't have any free time in the spring. But I got to announce a Providence seminar this year. I think I might do it in March next.
Melissa posted the link to Jeff Gellman Seminars.
Oh, thank you.
Brett, when you're working on obedience, are you focusing on one command at a time before moving on to the next one? Or can I introduce several commands throughout the day? You can do several throughout the day. Just make sure in the beginning, when you're laying your foundation, it's one at a time. But like, you can do down, put the dog away, then do place, put the dog away, then do recall. I don't start layering them until the dog has a really good understanding of all of the commands.
Mm.
Bara said hello to you both.
Bara, I'd like to say hello to you today. Next.
Sid, feet biting is why she came. Got dog 1 week ago. It's more than feet.
Yeah, I know. I mean, this was an example of someone else's comments, but you can stop biting by you say no and you put an inhibitor in there. Next.
Peter, hi, J&J.
Hey, how are you, Peter?
Barking Bakers, will you both be in Ramona this weekend?
So this is the first time that Joelle will not be traveling with me for the next, I'm doing two seminars in a row, so she'll be missing two seminars.
So weird.
So don't get used to it. I'm not going to get used to it. You better not get used to it because she'll be back. But Joelle needs to stay in Providence. Next.
Melissa posted the link to your Patreon channel.
Thank you. Patreon is good. Patreon's really, really good. A lot of good stuff going on in Patreon. A lot of seminar videos that go up there that are not seen. They're not seen anywhere.
Sarah said it works so well.
Well, good. Excellent. Thank you.
$4.99 from the Noble Dogs. What are the protocols to eventually petting a human aggressive dog at your facility? Once counter conditioned, do you wear a glove, pet with a towel?
Sometimes I come out of the shower with a towel wrapped around my naked body, dripping with water. I just walk over to a dog and randomly pet it. So I think you should try that. Petting with a towel is good. Just be careful because you want to make sure that towel is tied tight, because there's nothing worse than petting a dog and having your towel drop to the floor. It's a bad position to be in. It's a really bad
position. What's wrong with you?
Well, let me ask what the public's opinion is on that. Okay. For the next.
Frank, 20 times a day, slow dog or slow owner? What's the question, Frank?
Well, you're Frank. What kind of, is there a question? 20 times a day, you want to do reps. Lots of reps. Lots of reps. Next.
Oh, Macy.
I think we're both dragging today. And we drove.
I didn't get any sleep last night.
Why not? It seems like you slept in.
No, we didn't go to bed till almost 1 a.m. when we got back from.
We got back at midnight.
Yeah.
Parked the RV, plugged in.
I probably got like 5 hours of sleep. That's not enough for me.
Oh my God, I was up at 3:30.
Ugh. Macy, hi J&J. Thanks for all the free videos.
Both dragging. That's for sure.
I love your training methods. I'm finding them very helpful to train my 1-year-old GSD.
Good. Keep it up, because that 1-year-old dog is going to keep progressing. And you're going to have your hands full there. Next.
Kathleen, haha, 4 hours was 2 years ago. Listen to the whole thing. Best New Year's Eve yet. Really?
Kathleen, don't give.
Kathleen's an OG super fan. I love her.
Don't give Joelle any ideas. This is one of the puppies.
4 hours. Leashes. Kaylani said, what's Joelle's channel? I got to get in shape.
So you can go to patreon.com, Joelle Gifford, and have your life changed.
Melissa posted the link. Melissa
posted up, yeah.
Thank you. Sarah said COVID dogs.
I mean, the great thing about having COVID dogs is people have time to train them. The not great thing is that a lot of them are going to have separation anxiety because people are not doing post-COVID training. But it's not their fault, so that's up to us to, you know, educate them.
CMM said, love y'all.
I love you too.
Becky, how do you answer a client that is convinced their dog is dumb?
Well, how do I answer them? I would just explain that their dog you just need to learn how to motivate their dog. Their dog's not dumb. Next.
Jamie, hello, hope all is well. I'm having some issues walking my dachshund as he's extremely slow. I have to keep giving him small tugs to keep up. How can I get him to keep up with me?
I mean, for a dachshund, you want to first make sure the dog doesn't have, first of all, it's a dachshund. Every dachshund doesn't walk like a greyhound, you know, or a Malinois. Make sure the dog doesn't have any spinal issues. It's very common for dachshunds to have spinal issues. But you can definitely just teach your dog a better heel, which is to walk next to you. A lot of dogs, people have pulling dogs, but slow movers are, you know, also a problem as well. So heel is next to you, you know, right behind your knee. My gosh. It's a really rough one.
Wake up.
I know, little Susie. Next.
Megan.
Next punch, next thing.
Mini educator or educator for bloodhound pups had to get a boss for their dad, but we adopted him after he got fired from being a hunting dog and was high drive chasing deer, etc. Was able to call him off without getting to the highest boss levels.
Some bloodhounds, some any fill in the blank breed needs more stimulation.
Yeah.
But there's bloodhounds that are probably low level correctors. So, I mean, it doesn't hurt to get the boss. Like my father always said, Jeff, when you buy a briefcase, get one of the bigger size briefcases because you can always not use it all. But if you get a small briefcase and you need more, you're out of luck. Mm. Irv's got good advice like that.
It's true. Yep. Tosh, you're a good man, Jeff. That's what sets you apart from many. You give a lot of shit about people and will always be thankful for you being there when I needed you.
Tash, thank you for the kind words.
That's nice.
And I think you summed me up very, very well.
Jeff gives a shit.
But it's really funny how, for some reason, the public doesn't get that. But I really don't care what they think. But when you get to know who I am as a human being, that's usually what the response is next.
David, our dog sleeps in house in crate every night. I think she might be ready to be out of the crate. Any advice if this is a good or a bad idea?
Well, that's a personal choice. I mean, I would ask you, like, my dogs sleep in crates. Why do you want to have your dog sleep out of a crate? Right? Next. But it's a personal choice. I mean, a crate is safe. They're sleeping. Why not just have them sleep in the crate? Next.
Timothy, hey, do you still have spots to do the DC seminar? I've done so well with my dog. Looking forward to a live seminar.
Do you still have many? Yeah, because we just announced it. Yeah, there's spots. Right now, there's spots at all the seminars because we just announced them. In 2021, people really aren't thinking about, you know, buying seminar tickets. So there's absolutely spots. But every one of our seminars will sell out because we've shrunk them down in size because of COVID. Next.
Frank, I was just thinking out loud about kenneling 20 times. Seems like a lot.
No. Kennel up. Let's go. Kennel up. Let's go. Kennel up. Let's go. Even with you, Frank. Forward, reverse. Forward, reverse. Forward, reverse. You can do it. Next.
Joe.
But I'm sorry. But, you know, if you're trying to get your dog proficient in something, you want to do it hundreds of times. Next.
Joe, if you miss the opportunity to bonk e-collar on high during loading and dog is already reacting to a dog you didn't see coming, should you still correct?
Well, you should, but it might not work because when the alcoholic is sitting at the bar on their third drink, keeping them sober is out the window. Next.
Kathy, oh, cool about the New Year's Eve show. I hope you have one. That would be fun.
Whoa. Kathy B.
Kathleen, like, you're putting all these things in people's minds.
We never discussed this. This is not under discussion. I didn't even realize it until 10 minutes ago. And you know me. I
don't know if you can hang till midnight. I can't remember the last time I stayed
up. Look at us now.
Midnight.
It's 7:25 and we're both falling asleep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next.
Let's see. Brianna, are you doing any internships? Would love to learn from you guys and train with you.
So right now our internship is on hold because we've got people coming in. Then we're reevaluating our internship program. If we want to have people here. What the thing about interns is we love them. It takes a lot of time away from the trainers though to get the work done unless they come in with a really good skill set. That's the hard thing. Next.
J-Ron, howdy y'all. Did I just witness Joelle bonking Jeff? Get some rest, folks. Y'all deserve it.
No, she full out punched me. That was what you call a punch.
It was not a full on punch though.
That was pretty hard.
No, it wasn't.
If I punched you at 1/10 of that, you would be yelling and screaming,
bullshit,
complaining all day long.
Bullshit. It was not that hard. Go ahead. Punch me.
No, I'm not going to punch you.
Go ahead.
I will not punch you.
Okay. Next. Irene, LOL, towel. You're so silly, Jeff. I thought that was a legitimate question regarding pet aggressive dogs, similar to when to remove the muzzle when you're working a human aggressive dog. I've often wondered that too.
I guess I'd never really answered that question. So I think a lot of it, Grant and Irene, is instinct on when to pet the dog. It's literally instinct. I'm in no rush to pet dogs that are biting dogs. My main goal is to stop biting. And a lot of the dogs that we bite us even without petting them. So I think when you can sort of tell when they get into a really good space. Mm-hmm. You can see it in them. Mm-hmm. You can feel it. When you work as many dogs as we do, you can actually start feeling the dog that, like, wow, you're feeling really good. Next.
Sarah, it shows that you care. Thank you for being you. You helped me with my dog so much. He's an amazing dog now. He pulled like a crazy dog. 20 pounds felt like huge. You give easy instructions. You teach people how to communicate with their pets. Thank you.
Sarah, I think, again, you sort of summed it up.
Everyone write a review on Jeff tonight.
No, please don't do that. No. I don't need that.
All the trolls come out.
I don't need that. Trust me. Like, how many times are we allowed to say asshole in
Describe
one sentence?
Describe Jeff in one word.
That's right. Is asshole one word or two words? Cocktail.
That was not even funny. I think that was on the Friday show. I think Kathy B missed that.
You know, it was Publix.
Conk. That was funny. I laughed way too hard at that. It hurt. I like strained a muscle.
You went through 12 cells on Instagram stories.
You tell the waitress, I want her removed from the table. Which made me laugh even more.
Kex.
I just imagined her dragging me out. Ma'am, you're laughing too much.
That's right.
Let's see. Timothy, thanks for doing what you do. The bond I've achieved with my dog from your techniques is amazing.
You know, Timothy, you bring up a really good point there. Thank you so much. It's funny. We did show something in stories with myself and a German Shepherd. I was sitting on the floor. Joelle and I did a wonderful consulting day. I travel the world, well, the United States now, doing consulting for many different companies. And I do a lot of virtual, I do a ton of, but you can actually hire me for 2 days to come out to your company. And we go over everything. We went over training, you know, behavior mod, client relations. We had private one-on-one talks with the owner about like the setup of the company. We talked about a lot of social media. We talk a lot about state of mind. We talk about a lot of things, but they had a dog there that was a German Shepherd that was biting up at the owner's arm. And now they stopped that, but now it was obsessively licking. Mm. Like we're talking excessive hand. It licks it. So I said, bring the dog out. And so German Shepherd, you've seen the video. So I've never met the dog before. I don't even know the dog's name. I don't even know if it was actually a male or a female. It was definitely a German Shepherd. I remember that. So I just corrected it for licking. And I did it a bunch of times because it would go from like
a bunch of licks to like one.
Licks to like half as many licks to like one lick to like lick it. Oh, shit, I'm not supposed to lick to like it couldn't help it. It was like, yeah. it was an OCD
it was
licker.
Very like OCD.
OCD licker. And then I sat down on the ground and the dog got on the ground. He's on his belly. He's on his back. I mean, and then he like snuggles up underneath my leg and I'm petting him. And I'm like, literally all I have done with this dog,
literally
all I have done with this dog is correct him. That's it.
There was no good or, you didn't lick. Good job.
No, there was no rewards. And trust me, in our training, we do that. But I'm saying it's like, when you see the interaction they have with this dog, you'd be like, wow, this dog really likes Jeff. And Jeff actually cares about dogs. And imagine owning a dog and building a really great relationship by having that nice conversation about this is acceptable, this is not acceptable. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what people need to understand, that people really think that corrections distance yourself from your dog, but they actually bring you closer together. More than the holidays do, I think.
It gives clarity. I could imagine just going through life not knowing what's right and what's wrong. It's
right.
Just like,
it's no different than when, you know, Mac goes on the trails with us now, and on Saturday morning, Angelo went with us. He goes hiking with us through the trails, and Angelo had his sandwich down. No, that was Bert. I had my sandwich down. Angelo had a croissant. Yeah. I had my sandwich down. And Mac came up from behind me and took a bite out of it. And I'm like, you know, what the fuck?
He didn't know.
So he didn't know.
He's never learned.
Yeah. So I called the Mac over to me and I put my sandwich down again, and he tried to do it again. He learned really quick not to take a bite out of my sandwich. And guess what?
I can't believe he did that.
And guess what?
It's like a perfect bite mark out of it.
He's still, I still eat it. I mean, I'm not going to fucking pay $4.09 for a goddamn sandwich and not eat it. I don't care if a dog friggin' took a bite out of it or not. I would almost open up his mouth and.
And then Bert almost did it to Angelo.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like, no.
So I think they had a meeting.
Hey, they bring food every morning.
That's right. It's like, I'll tell you what.
We charge in 5 minutes.
You go for the dad. You go for the son.
Yeah.
And Bert was like, damn right. I'm not going towards Jeff. His corrections are rough. I'll go towards Angela.
Bert's like, I'll just take the kids' food.
I'll take the kids' food. I'll go for the easy mark.
And Angela was like he didn't even care. He's like slightly handing it to him. Like, hey, so, Bert.
So, but, and the dog's not afraid of me.
No.
The dog's not afraid of going on the walks. Dog's not afraid of, like, it's all... All this stuff, like when you do a correction, when you mark it and you do it from an unemotional standpoint, man, you want to talk about clarity?
Yeah.
There's clarity. Mm-hmm. There's clarity. I mean, think about.
And, you know, remember you pointed it out too after you corrected Mac. How many times did he check in with you when normally he's off doing his own fucking thing? He was like, where's Jeff? Where's Jeff? Where's Jeff?
I think it's almost like couples arguing. Like they get to a point where they don't even know what they're arguing about anymore. Mm-hmm. So there's no clarity at all.
Yeah.
There's no clarity in the relationship. And I think it's pretty similar. Next.
Timothy, thanks for doing it. I already read that. Kathy B said, it's not that far off. It's December 2nd, LOL.
It is coming up. But in my world, that's a long time. Next.
CMM, 5-month puppy snaps at my hand when training a trick. How do I correct that? Train 3 times a day with food and he's gentle eating from hand. It's just when I put a treat above his nose and tell him, wait, thanks.
Well, there's a couple of things you can do. You can say no and bonk him in the head. You can say no and use your hand to correct. You can make sure, I would probably bonk the dog. No and then bonk. Next.
Emma, so my puppy had his food super limited due to a nutrition deficiency. He's 4 months now and finally up to 2 cups a day. But he scarfs down his food and is constantly on the search for food due to this. Any advice? I'm worried about food aggressive in the future.
I mean, it doesn't necessarily. Well, you can eliminate food aggression in 1 second. So, Emma, if that ever happens, just let me know and I'll tell you how to eliminate. Resource gardening is a 1 second fix. That's why all these folks that are like, you know, kill the dog or, oh, you need all these like fancy protocols, all these acronyms on it. And it's like, no, no. No,
you gotta hand feed the dog every meal for the rest of his life.
No. You can fix resource guarding in 1 second. So what I would do is I would take the food and just spread it out on the cement or on the grass, or you can
muffin tins,
baking sheets. Next.
Megan, thanks so much. I was thinking of getting the mini because it would fit a 4 to 5 month old bloodhound puppy's size better. But they'll grow pretty fast. Would a boss be too big for that size pup? Do you ever use the educator, not mini? Or do you usually go up to the boss if the mini isn't enough?
So the box is about the same, though. The box on the boss is about the same.
It's a little bit bigger.
Yeah, a little bit, but not that much.
Not major.
Not that much bigger, yeah. And also, you can still have a mini educator on a 200-pound dog. Next.
Keith, I love watching your stuff. My husky pup just turned 1 year old, and she's flourished. She's very well-behaved and listens like she can understand my words. As a first-time dog owner, thank you.
Well, Keith, you definitely, getting a husky as a first-time dog, you definitely took a bite out of things, a bite out of the dog world that could have, that's bigger than most people can actually swallow. And
you mean you could actually train your husky?
Recall too.
Whoa.
Yeah. And this is the thing though. So Keith, what you're really trying to say is you busted your ass doing your reps and incorporating the training. I just talk. I show, I talk, I demonstrate. I answer questions. I rant. But just always remember that knowledge is not power. A lot of people like that. They say that quote. Knowledge is power.
Knowledge is power.
Actually, no, it's not. That's a false statement. The application of knowledge is what real power is. Next.
Ooh. Kathy B., the foster I have, gave me a shitty look when I clipped her second nail. She got corrected and then got to wear a muzzle. No snarl or growl, just that look. And I knew she was thinking about it. Hell no.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There's that's what you really need to be in tune with, because that's where that, if you're not in tune with that, that's when folks are like,
they bit out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere, it was random, or they didn't give a sign. It's like, oh, they gave a sign.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
Andrea, thank you for all you do. I learned so much.
You're welcome, Andrea.
Abandoned entity. I feel like I had a setback today. Heel was pretty good, inside sores, lows, etc. But when we did it today, my dad decided to bring along his dog, who's untrained and reactive. Mm-hmm. Mine kept looking for his when they split up, like it was making him anxious when apart. They never walked together either. I couldn't get him to stop being squirrely. He isn't reactive, but it was ugly.
So, abandoned entity, just keep in mind. What was last month? November?
Mm-hmm.
So, the month of November, the first 10 days of the month, sales-wise, were terrible. Horrific. Crickets. Last month, we probably had the best month in 2020, month of November. But the first 10 days were terrible. So when you look at things, and you can even have 2-3 bad months, but then the next 9 months are outstanding. When you look at things from a macro instead of a micro, and when you look at things at big picture, or even, you know, 2-year, 3-year, 4-year, 5-year cycles, you get a better idea of it. But when you're looking at things from a daily cycle, it's easy to be, what's the word? Disheartened. So
discouraged.
So let's start falling in love with the roller coaster ride of dog training. Next.
Melissa posted the link to your community, or the text community, the number.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, everybody jump on your phones right now and text me. I don't even know it by heart yet. At 401-341-1903, just send me a text. You'll get an autoresponder. It's the only automatic thing you'll get. Everything else comes from me organically. And I never know what I'm going to text you.
Oh, it's a surprise.
Yep. Next.
Abandoned entity. Then my dad's dog saw a dog and reacted, which affected mine. And ugly became uglier. No reaction, but totally tuned out, spazzy. The bad days aren't frequent, but they still suck.
They do. So now you know what you're going to do? You're going to role play it. So now you've got a great situation and a great,
yeah, new thing to work
on. A great thing to work on, and just tell your dad to keep not training his dog, and you then use that dog as your
proofing.
As your proofing. Next.
Kathy B. Sandwich. So as long as they don't pee on it, like in National Lampoon's Vacation.
Well, that all depends on the sandwich. I mean, on the way to our consulting job, we stopped at a vegan restaurant and I had a tempeh Reuben. And if there was a little bit of dog urine on there, I might have still had it. It was a good sandwich.
That bowl I got though?
Right.
So good.
So let's say there was a couple little sprinkles on there from the dog. Really?
Hell no. Yeah,
more food for me. Next.
J. Ron, can we
keep that in mind? Maybe I'll keep a little bottle with a little
with piss.
With a little squirt
thing. A tincture in there. Of piss.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
Take golden showers whenever you want. J. Ron, can we expect an appearance from Angelo looking for a late night snack?
No, not tonight. Not tonight. Tomorrow I leave for California and then Phoenix.
Damn, we're not gonna have Angelo at work for like 2 weeks.
Yeah, but then I'm back here for almost 3 months. So Angelo and Romeo will be here. We have a full house. We have to set up a little classroom.
Wish I was going to the Sunshine States.
For sure, too. Too late now. I've actually canceled your ticket last night.
I saw the confirmation.
Last night. I'm like.
Felt like a dagger well, to the chest.
I wanted to get the credit.
Cancel my fucking
flight. I waited until the very last minute. And trust me, it's going to hurt me a lot not to have you there.
CMM. My name is Christine. Thank you. Y'all have changed my relationship with my dog. We thought he was psycho. Now he's becoming very disciplined. I get him and love him now. 5-month-old dog.
So, Christine, there seems to be a little theme going on here where people are really building relationships with their dogs by watching our content.
Mm.
And for some reason, and you know why? They're doing the work.
Right.
That I put out. But for some reason, the people that just watch the videos make false assumptions that it would do the opposite of what Christine just said. Couldn't be wrong. Are wrong. It's far, the farthest thing from the truth.
Couldn't be more wrong.
Couldn't be more wrong. I forgot a word there.
Take that sound bite. See?
The more.
You misspeak all the time and it completely changes.
I remember he made a clicker error. He doesn't know anything about clicker training.
He's not a clicker
because training. He misspoke once. Because I listened to his show and I put it through my speech analysis.
I made a typo the other day in a video I made. I made a typo. I was like, oh shit. Really? And it completely changed the whole point of escape conditioning. I'm like, the dog's learning how to turn pressure on. No, Joelle, the dog's learning how to turn pressure on. Off. I'm like, how long was that up there for? It's like one word can really change the meaning of things there.
It sure can.
Yep.
Texting something to somebody to the wrong person can really change
things. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You got to watch out.
Double, triple, quadruple text.
It's true.
All my siblings start with J, too. So I'm like, going to make sure I'm texting the right one before I start talking shit.
I actually called your sister today. Because I called her first thing in the morning because she does... one of her sisters is a very talented, I don't want to call her, yeah, she's an artist. But
she's an artist.
She works with wood and paint, and she made these wonderful, wonderful ornaments, tree ornaments. And I called her up, and I wanted her to get a couple of them made for me. And I'm like, and she's like, you know, I mean, they take a long time. She's hand-making them. And then I actually went to go pick up these two doodles. And then I called. I was going to call Joelle. I'm like, oh, by the way, I just got the doodles. I'm heading back. Can you get the crates ready for them? And there was a silence. And I'm like, I looked at my phone because I don't
hold my... She didn't say, like, hey, wrong number. She just gets silent and awkward. Yeah, like,
so...
maybe Jeff just wants to talk to
me. She probably knew it was me because my name...
About doodles.
Flashes up. So...
Everyone mixes us up in the family.
But I never do, though, because I never call her.
Yeah.
I never call her. I never text her. So... I think that's the second time I've ever talked to her on the phone. Yeah.
Kathy, thank you both. You helped me so much with how to explain things to clients. You are greatly appreciated for all that you say and do. It's also cool that the show and Patreon are fun.
Kathy B, thank you. This is like the night of kind words.
I know.
I'm feeling. You just canceled the fucking...
It's because it was my left hand. I'm sorry. Okay.
Stop. It's like...
You're making the puppies
bark. No, you canceled the fucking show.
We're back, though.
Okay, now we're back. Quiet.
Now we got barking puppies.
Bonk those dogs.
We're still here.
No.
Oh, good aim.
Damn right.
Holy shit, from across the room.
Yeah, I know a bonk.
Okay. Sorry, guys. Still here. Did you have anything else you wanted to say?
No. I mean, every time I talk about fueling the love, you cancel the show.
Cassie, you mentioned separation anxiety due to COVID togetherness. Watched your separation anxiety video. We seem to have fixed crate anxiety when we are in different areas of the house with a rope system and jingly cans to disrupt the whining, barking, escaping. He does not do these things if we are in view. No normal separation anxiety indicators until we go to a different floor of the house or go outside, but not sure what to do when we leave. 5-month-old Great Pyrenees.
Start role playing it, but use a remote collar. Get yourself a proper shock collar, remote collar. Say they are the same thing. E-collar Technologies, dog truck, okay, two different brands. And put a video camera on the dog and correct your dog for all its nonsense. People will say that it'll create a negative association in the crate. That's an outright blatant lie. People will say it'll make the dog worse. That's an outright blatant lie. People say the dog will hate the crate. That's an outright blatant lie. Why? 10,000 dogs. We're still doing it. It works every time. Next.
Edge, hello, your expertise. What e-collar is better for success, mini educator or dog to arc for teaching husky off-leash, as well as first-time e-collar user as well, so looking for friendly use?
Okay, skill set more than the tool. Please keep in mind, guys, that from food all the way to shock collars, they are tools. They're communication tools. The skill set behind the tool is what is the most important thing. Both of the collars you mentioned are good quality collars. Either one will work. It's the skill set that will determine the success. Next.
Medusa, what would Jeff do? My dog is neutered, paid no attention to my female in heat. I'm cautioning all, although I had eyes on them. His penis got stuck out. I had to bring him to the emergency room.
So,
oh, that's unfortunate.
Next time, what you can do is either finish him off.
Oh my God.
Or you can take some olive oil and rub it around the base and put it back in. When talking balls are totally out,
ugh,
it's not a pretty sight.
That's disgusting.
Yeah. Yeah.
Balls can come out too.
Everything comes
really?
Out. It all comes out because they use them to lock in. They insert flange and then they stay mounted. You never saw two dogs stuck together?
No.
Yeah, my chihuahuas have been stuck together before. Want to see two chihuahuas?
Flange.
Yeah, they pop out like flanging, like a flange.
Interesting.
Yeah, it's like those little amoeba that go up your penis and then spring out little sharp barbs so you can't pull them out. When you're like waiting and wasting
water. I cannot. That is why you don't go in warm southern water.
Yeah. Well, this is over in.
You can also get brain-eating amoebas.
Yeah. Those are popular right now, by the way.
Scary shit.
I know. Water source.
Like, you guys ever watch Monsters Inside Me?
Water sources are changing.
Sure are.
Next.
Abandoned entity. I really needed to hear that. He's come a long way from the ball of anxiety that he used to be. That's usually what feeds into being discouraged. I worry a lot about going backwards.
Well, you know,
so bright right now.
Some of the best personal growth that I've experienced in life has created the most wonderful results on the other side of that. Just remember, on the other side of discomfort is always success, historically. Next.
Justin, hey guys, if I remember correctly, you said I should train separately and then have them work off each other. Tips or vids for starting that?
No, you don't need any tips or videos. You just did it. You just explained it perfectly well. Next.
Timothy, honestly, watching your videos has helped me attain an unbelievable connection with my dog. Oh, thanks.
Thank you. A lot of bonding and connecting going
on. Time to shut the show off again.
Yeah.
I don't know how I did that. What did I do? I hit it with my left hand. That's why. There's no control over this one. It doesn't know what it's doing.
I don't know what you did.
Medusa said, I signed a contract not to spay until her first heat. That's the only reason she was fixed before. And thank you.
You're welcome.
Justin. Also, I really enjoy your text messages. Nice to have somebody other than my mom and girlfriend text me. LOL.
So
I can relate.
Justin. jump on Tinder. Get some friends, buddy.
He's got a girlfriend.
Uh-huh. And?
That's a real punch.
Ow! Ow!
I do not condone that behavior, Justin. Don't listen to
him. Why are you yelling at him for?
Because. Next. Sarah. Pyrenees surrendered to the shelter. Very severe food aggression. Do I correct high with e-collar or would you suggest your out command videos with e-collar, obviously? If trained with us and resource guarding is eliminated with us, what is the chance of it sticking with the dog when it gets adopted? Is there a high chance for the behavior will return with the new family?
It could, but you'll teach the new family what to do. So you're going to do out with the e-collar, which is the same as, that's how you do it. That's how you do it. So I've got a free video on our website that tells you how to stop resource guarding. Next.
Michael, love you guys. E-collar correction, no, then tap. No, then double tap. Can the word and the tap be at the same time? Thank you.
No, you want to say no first. No is your marker word. So use a marker. Yes, and then deliver the reward, which historically is food, physical touch, a ball, a tug. And no is then uncomfortable. That's something that's uncomfortable or a consequence or an inhibitor. Next.
Kathy B., the candiru fish, a.k.a. the penis fish. Yes. Nasty little bastards.
Oh, my God. Yeah, you know all about them. Yeah.
Kathleen. Okay, I never knew how big dog dicks were. I literally thought it was just the little lipstick until a friend in vet school Snapchatted me a pic from her lecture. Oh, my God. Wes, knock it off.
You start talking about dog dicks.
Wes is like, I need to be part of this conversation.
Sorry. Let me tell you about my dick.
He's still got his balls, too.
He sure does.
Justin said, ha, 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 all caps. My girlfriend will correct me at level 100 for sure.
Yep, exactly.
Mike, hope I didn't miss any good rants, but we'll catch up via podcast. Thanks for what you do.
You know, Mike, tonight's been a really low-key show to the point of, like, could you imagine if it was like this every week? We'd lose people. This is why it was, like... You know, my God, you yell so much and you're so like, ranty and yada, yada, yada. Because I'm thinking this show is really slow paced and I'm exhausted right now. Mm-hmm. So I think that I can't imagine just doing a podcast like this.
No.
Yeah. I like to be more, a little bit more, a couple steps up. Next.
Holding on, dog training, stuck together. Once that happens, it's just a waiting game.
Yep.
Gross. Sarah said, thank you.
You're welcome, Sarah.
Dory said, hey, Gal.
Hey, how are you?
That's it.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Because you didn't rant at all. We went through all the questions.
7:52.
No rants from Jeff.
8 minutes left. So tomorrow I leave here at 6 a.m. Head to California. Got a nice upgrade for the 5.5-hour second leg.
Oh, canceled my flight. Upgraded to first class. Did you?
For a lot cheaper than your, I use my points. Mm. It's like, what am I doing with all these points? Mm. So I'm flying United. I got a shitload of points. I'm like, what am I doing with all these points? So 20,000 points. I got a lot of upgrades available. Yeah. Remember, didn't we take a flight one time with just using upgrades?
Probably.
I think we did. Yeah.
Diana said safe travels.
Thank you.
Cassie, thank you for the crate advice and for all of your content. Really, I didn't know what the minimum age for e-collars was, but I will follow your methods and recommendations in your videos with one. When do you recommend starting a prong collar with a puppy?
I mean, depends on the size of the puppy. I mean, if you got yourself a little, if you put it this way, if you got yourself a Rottweiler, German Shepherd, Great Dane, 12 or 14 weeks, definitely. I mean, for a lot of breeds of dogs, I think it's more about like, are they pulling your arm off down the street and do you have the skill set to stop it? And getting the dog desensitized getting used to the prong and pressure around its neck, I think is really, really important. Next.
That's it.
So before Joelle shuts the show off again, why don't we just head out? Hope everybody, I'm going to miss everybody for the next week. But I will. 2 weeks. Yeah.
You're gone for like 14
days.
I will
not be back until 2 weeks from today. Yeah. Because I come back Monday night.
Today's Wednesday.
After the show, though.
Yeah.
After the show. So that means that I think I come back. No, maybe not. I might be here Monday. So anyway, love you guys.
Good night.
Take care. Bye-bye.